وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. In our last episode, we spoke about the seerah of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to speak about the second figure from the ten that were promised Jannah. And that is none other than Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Umar's name is Umar ibn al-Khattab ibn Nufayl. His name is Umar ibn al-Khattab ibn Nufayl ibn Adi ibn Abd al-Uzza ibn Riyah ibn Qurt ibn Razah ibn Adi ibn Ka'b ibn Lu'ay. So he comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Adi. So he's Bani Adi ibn Ka'b ibn Lu'ay. This is where he comes. He's Amir al-Mu'mineen and his kunya is Abu Hafs al-Qurashi al-Adawi. That's al-Adawi comes from Adi ibn Ka'b ibn Lu'ay. This is where him and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam meet. Al-Faruq, that's his nickname. He died the year when it was 23 Hijriya, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. His mother's name is Hantama bintu Hisham al-Makhzumiyya. So automatically a lot of you guys already know who is the son of Hisham al-Makhzumiyya. Hisham al-Makhzumi, who is his son? It's Abu Jahl. So that would mean that Umar radiallahu ta'ala's mother and Abu Jahl are brothers and sisters. Hantamatu bintu Hisham al-Makhzumiyya is the sister of Abu Jahl. ولذلك Abu Jahl is the maternal uncle of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And that's something a lot of you guys can benefit and take. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he accepted Islam and embraced Islam في السنة السادسة من النبوة. He took it the sixth year of the Prophet's prophecy. يعني after Nabi Muhammad became a prophet, 6 years after he accepted Islam. And his age was 27 سنة. He was 24 years of age when he accepted and he embraced al-Islam. Abu Bakr, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was 27 سنة. He was 24 years of age. And Nabi Muhammad had come out as a prophet 6 years now. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abdullah ibn Umar, who is the son of Umar ibn Khattab, he said, كَانَ أَبِي أَبْيَضَ. He said, my father was white, لَكِنْ تَعْلُوهُ حُمْرَةٌ. There was a lot of redness in his face. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abu Raja al-Utaridi, he said, كَانَ طَوِيلًا جَسِيمًا. Umar was very tall, and he was also not skinny. He had weight. شَدِيدَ الْحُمْرَةِ. He said he was red, excessively red. في عارضيه خفة. And he had hair on his, يعني his two sides. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abdullah ibn Umar even mentioned, he said, كَانَ أَبِي, my father was أَبْيَضَ, my father was white. تَعْلُوهُ حُمْرَةً طُوَّالًا. And he said, my father was tall as well. Umar was a very tall person, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Also, Abdullah ibn Umar, him narrated and he mentioned min wujuhin, many different ways, all of which are authentic. Also, Aisha mentioned the same, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud mentioned the same, and all of them you can find it in the Mustadrak of Abi Abdullah al-Hakim al-Naysaburi, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, and all of these sahabas, Aisha, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, all of them narrated it from the Prophet alayhi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and it's all authentic, alhamdulillah, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, Allahumma, the Prophet made his dua. He said, Allahumma a'izz al-Islam bi Umar ibn al-Khattab. Oh Allah, bring honor to Islam through Umar ibn al-Khattab. ولذلك Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه, he mentioned, he said, ما زلنا We were consistent. يعني we were always عزة منذ أسلم عمر. The day that Umar embraced Islam. The day that Umar embraced Islam, honor is what came to us. رضي الله تعالى عنه. عكرمة, he said, لم يزل الإسلام في اختفاء حتى أسلم عمر. Before Umar came, they were hiding Islam. They weren't coming out. They were not coming out. They were hiding it. The day Umar accepted Islam, everyone was coming out. No one was scared anymore. Umar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him that. Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما, may Allah be pleased with him and his father. He said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet said, إن لي وزيرين من أهل السماء ووزيرين من أهل الأرض. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إن لي وزيرين, I have two wazirs. من أهل السماء, from the sky. ووزيرين من أهل الأرض, and two وزير, ministers, ambassadors. From the two in the sama and two on the earth. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَوَزِيرَايَ مِنْ أَهْلِ السَّمَاءِ جِبْرِيلُ وَمِيكَائِلُ. It's Jibreel and Mikael from the sama. وَوَزِيرَايَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ أَبُو بَكْرٍ وَعُمَرَ. And as for the earth, it's Abu Bakr and Umar. We also took previously when we were speaking about Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he saw Abu Bakr and Umar walking, and the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, هَذَانِ سَيِّدَا كُهُولِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. That these two are the كُهُول أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. What does that mean? It means that they are the masters of the youths of Jannah. Hudhayfa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentioned, Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated it in his jami' and he graded it to be hasan, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اِقْتَدَوْ بِالَّذَيْنِ مِنْ بَعْدِي أبي بكر وعمر. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he instructed the Sahabas and he told them to hold on to أبي بكر and عمر, hold on to their path and their way رضي الله تعالى عنه. عبد العزيز بن المطلب ابن حنطب narrated from his father المطلب, who narrated from his father ابن حنطب, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting one day. يعني حنطب is saying, كنت جالسا عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I was sitting next to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one day. اطلع أبو بكر وعمر. أبو بكر and عمر came out onto the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet looked at both of them and he said, هذان السمع والبصر. These two individuals, أبو بكر and عمر, are like my ears and eyes. The role that my eyes and ears play, أبو بكر and عمر play those two roles. It was also narrated from Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas, he said, and the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the Prophet said, إيه يبن الخطاب. The Prophet said, إيه يبن الخطاب, فوالذي نفسي بيده ما لقيك شيطان سالكا فجا إلا سلك فجا غير فجك. The Prophet said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he swore by Allah, and we will believe the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, without the Prophet swearing by Allah. The Prophet swore by Allah. Look what he said. He said, فَوَلَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ, I swear by the Lord in which my soul is in his hand. مَا لَقِيَكَ شَيْطَانٌ. Umar, there is no shaytan that meets you on a path except that he will avoid that path. Whenever he sees you on that path, he will walk away from that path. He will avoid that path and he will take another path. He will take a what? ما لقيك الشيطان سالكا فجا إلا سلك فجا غير فجك. As soon as he sees that you're on that path, shaytan will try to go on another path. He will avoid you. The Prophet said that صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولذلك عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, may Allah be pleased with Aisha and her father Abu Bakr, she mentioned أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said في زفن الحبشة لما أتى عمر, when عمر came to the wedding, and the women, they ran away. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Umar, إِنِّي لَأَنظُرُ إِلَى شَيَاطِينِ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ قَدْ فَرُّ مِنْ عُمَرَ. I can see that the shayateen of the jinn and the ins, all of them, they ran away when Umar came. And Imam al-Tirmidhi authenticated this and he graded it to be sahih. Yani the people were dancing, the Abyssinians who were dancing, the word zafan is a raqs, it's those who are dancing and partying. When Umar entered, as soon as they saw Umar enter, they all ran away. Everyone ran away. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he smiled and he laughed and he said, "Inni la anzuru ila shayatin al jinni wal insi." I can see the shayatin al insi wal jinni, all of them running away when Umar entered. Abdullah ibn Buraydah, he narrated an abihi from his father, anna amatan sawda atat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa qad raja'a min ghazatin. The Prophet came back from an expedition, a battle, and a black woman came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and she said, "Inni nadartu, I made a nadr, an oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Irraddaka Allahu salihan. I had made an oath, a nadr with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that if Allah brings you back safe and sound, and adriba indaka bidufi, that I'm going to hit the duf, okay, in your presence, O Messenger of Allah. I'm going to hit the duf, okay." The Prophet then said to her, "In kunti nadarti fafali." If this is a nadr that you made, then do it. Fadarabat, she started to do the duf. فدخل أبو بكر أبو بكر entered وهي تضرب while she was doing the duff. ثم دخل عمر عمر entered فجعلت دفها خلفها. As soon as she saw عمر come, she took the duff that she was hitting and she placed it behind her back. وهي مقعية, and the woman was covering herself and hiding. فقال رسول الله, the messenger said, إن الشيطان لا يفرق منك يا عمر. The Prophet said to عمر رضي الله تعالى, يعني يفرق means أي يخاف. شيطان is scared of you, عمر. عمر, إبليس, شيطان scared of you. نعم. That's the type of person عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه was. عائشة, she mentioned, she said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, قد كان في الأمم محدثون. In the أمم, the nations, there were محدثون. محدثون, sorry. People that when they spoke, they got it right. And things happen to be in line with their words. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِنْ يَكُنْ فِي أُمَّتِي أَحَدٌ فَعُمَرُ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ. And if there's someone like this in this ummah, then it is Umar ibn al-Khattab. And Imam Muslim narrated that. Also, Abdullah ibn Umar, he mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَضَعَ الْحَقَّ عَلَى لِسَانِ عُمَرَ وَقَلْبِهِ. Allah, he placed the truth on the tongue of who? On the tongue of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So the Prophet referred to him as a muhaddith. And a muhaddith, I already mentioned, is al-mulhamun, الَّذِي يَجْرِي الصَّوَابُ عَلَى أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. The ones who, when they speak, the things go in line with them. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said that Allah placed the truth on the tongue of Umar and his heart. And the Sahabas recognized that, including Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to say, مَا كُنَّا نُبْعِدُ أَنَّ السَّكِينَةَ تَنْطَ طِقُوا عَلَى لِسَانِ عُمَرَى. Yani we never found it to be far that tranquility would be coming from the mouth of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And even he himself, Umar, mentioned three times that he said things which the Qur'an came in support of him. Umar radiallahu anhu, what did he say? وَافَقْتُ رَبِّي فِي ثَلَاثٍ. I went in line with my Lord in three things. Yani Umar said it and then the Qur'an came to support him. في مقام إبراهيم, the issue related to مقام إبراهيم, and the issue of the hijab. When he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, "Ya Rasulullah, tell your wives to wear hijab." And then the ayah came down, "Ya أيها النبي قل لأزواجك وبناتك ونساء المؤمنين يدينين عليهن من جلابيبهن." And also the ayah, عسى ربه إن طلقكن. Those three verses, they came that in support with Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه. Rather, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had a dream regarding Umar. Ibn Umar, he said, "I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, 'Baynama ana na'imun,' I was sleeping." The Prophet said, "Utitu biqadhim min labanin,' a cup of milk was brought to me. Fasharibtu minhu, and I drank from the cup." The Prophet saying this. This is the Prophet talking, alayhi sallam. The Prophet said, "I had a dream, and in this dream, a cup of milk was brought to me, and I drank it. Fasharibtu minhu, I drank from it." حتى إني لأرى الري يجري في أظفاري. And I saw that the quench of the milk, يعني the Prophet he drank it and the thirst and everything, it came out of his nails. And he drank so much that the milk was coming out of his nails, عليه الصلاة والسلام. ثم أعطيت, then I gave فضلي عمر. Whatever was leftovers from my milk after I drank it, and I got, يعني the Prophet said, I got, ما شاء الله. Then I gave it to عمر. I said, عمر, finish it off, I can't. And then Umar started to drink it. The people, they said, to the Prophet, فَمَا أَوَّلْتَ ذَلِكَ. What's your interpretation of that dream? What does that mean that you drank a milk and you gave it to Umar? What does that mean? The Prophet said, الْعِلْمَ, knowledge. Umar is going to take knowledge like that. Allahu Akbar. يعني the vastness of ilm, the knowledge of Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه. Abu Sa'id also mentioned that he said that the Prophet ﷺ said, بَيْنَمَا أَنَا نَائِمٌ. The Prophet had another dream. I was sleeping, the Prophet said. رَأَيْتُ النَّاسَ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيَّ وَعَلَيْهِمْ قُمُصٌ. The Prophet said, I had a dream. The people were being brought to me and they were wearing a garment. Okay? مِنْهَا مَا يَبْلُغُ الثُّدِيَّ وَمِنْهَا مَا يَبْلُغُ دُونَ ذَلِكَ. People's garments were, the length of the garment were different. Some people it was reaching their shin, some people it was reaching this, some it was reaching that, some يعني different places of their bodies. ومنها ما يبلغ ومر علي عمر. عمر came by me. عليه قميص. عمر was wearing a قميص. يجره, but his قميص was dragging on the ground. It was very long. قالوا, they said, ما أولت ذلك. What's your interpretation of the dream, O Messenger of Allah? The Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, الدين. This shows the vastness of Umar's religion, how vast it is. Now, brothers and sisters, as a side benefit, it's a mas'ala Abdul Rahman Yahya al-Mu'allimi speaks about it in great details, rahimahullah. He does touch on it in his kitab, Raf' al-Ishtibah. He also speaks about it in his kitab, Haqiqatul Bid'ah. And in other places of his works, Ibn Taymiyyah has already previously spoken about it. Other great scholars have touched on this. And that is this issue of a dream doesn't necessarily mean that it's a shar'i ruling. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam here mentioned Umar radiallahu anhu's garment will be dragging on the ground. That doesn't mean that it's permissible for a man's garment to drag. As we know, the man's garment is not allowed to be below his ankles. So what you see in your dream doesn't necessarily mean it's a reality. What do I mean by that, brothers and sisters? Someone might see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in their dream as they think they have. They assume they saw the Prophet in their dream sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what they see in their dream says to them, okay, you don't need to pray Dhuhr or Asr or Maghrib or Isha or Fajr. And the person wakes up and said, I saw the Prophet in my dream, alayhi salatu wasalam. And since I saw the Prophet in my dream and he told me I don't need to pray, I no longer have to pray. We'll say to that person, number one, that's not the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam which you saw. And that is definitely not a ruling that you should take on board. What you do is what you follow is what is in the Quran and the Sunnah. And this mas'ala regarding dreams and its reality, inshaAllah ta'ala, I will speak about it somewhere else, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. So sometimes the dreams can be things that are opposite to the shar'i ruling, but they have another interpretation. So the Prophet ﷺ here is explaining that the dragging of the garment of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu is what? Is the vastness of Umar's religion and how strong his deen is. It has nothing to do with the permissibility of what? Of a person's yani garment, a male's garment. Can it pull on the ground? Can it be below the ankles? It's not talking about that. So I hope you'll have taken that on board and understood that. Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَرْحَمُ أُمَّتِي أَبُو بَكْرٍ. The most merciful person in my ummah is Abu Bakr. وَأَشَدُّهَا فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ عُمَرٍ. And the one that's the strongest and toughest on the religion is Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Also, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned another dream he had. Abu Hurairah narrated this and he said that the Prophet ﷺ said, بَيْنَمَا أَنَا نَائِمٌ. The Prophet said, I was sleeping. رَأَيْتُنِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ فَإِذَا مْرَأَةً تَتَوَضَّ إِلَى جَانِبِ قَصْرٍ. I saw a woman. So the Prophet said, I was sleeping. And the Prophet was in Jannah. And he saw a woman doing wudu. And she was doing wudu إِلَى جَانِبِ قَصْرٍ. The woman was doing wudu on the side of a beautiful palace. فَقُلْتُ, I said, لِمَنْ هَذَا الْقَصْرُ. Who is that يعني palaces? Who owns this palace? قَالُوا, they said to me, the Prophet said, لِعُمَرَ. That's Umar's palace. فَذَكَرْتُ غِيرَةَ عُمَرَ. The Prophet then said, I remember the protective jealousy of Umar. فَوَلَّيْتُ مُدْبِرًا. I didn't look at the woman, I turned my back. فَبَكَى عُمَرُ. Umar cried and he said, بِأَبِي أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَعَلَيْكَ أَغَارُ. Umar cried and he said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, am I going to be jealous of you? Protective jealous of you? يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, I trust you, عليه الصلاة والسلام. You're the Prophet of Allah. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that. Ali ibn Abi Talib, one day he stood on the pulpit of Kufa. And he did this fi mala'in min an-nasi. He did this in the presence of many people. This was ayyam khilafati, the days of his khilafa. Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, khayru hadhi al-ummati ba'da nabiyha Abu Bakr. The best man after Nabiullah Muhammad is Abu Bakr. Wa khayruha ba'da Abi Bakr Umar. And after Abu Bakr, the best person is Umar. وَلَوْ شِئْتُ أَنْ أُسَمِّيَ الثَّالِثَ. If you want me to tell you the third person, لَسَمَّيْتُ. I can tell you who it is. This, brothers and sisters, Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, he said, وَهَذَا مُتَوَاتِرٌ عَنْ عَلِيٍّ. وَهَذَا, this is مُتَوَاتِرٌ عَنْ عَلِيٍّ. This is mutawatir, multitude, mass transmission of Ali ibn Abi Talib in saying this about Abu Bakr and Umar. And look what he said after that, Al-Imam al-Dhahabi. And he said, "Alam Nubala." He said, "فَقَبَّحَ اللَّهُ الرَّافِضَةَ." فَقَبَّحَ اللَّهُ الرَّافِضَةَ. فَقَبَّحَ اللَّهُ الرَّافِضَةَ. May Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala destroy the Rafida who say otherwise. Aisha, she said, Abu Bakr said, Aisha heard this from her father, Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr, one day he said, "مَا عَلَى ظَهْرِ الْأَرْضِ رَجُلٌ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ عُمَرَ." Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she heard her father Abu Bakr saying, "There is nobody on the face of this earth today more beloved to me than Umar." Abu Bakr said that. Aisha also mentioned, "Dakhala nasun ala Abi Bakr." A group of people, they entered onto Abu Bakr, fi maradihi, when he was on his deathbed. And they said to him, "Yasa'uka an tuwalli alayna Umar wa anta dahibun ila rabbik." Do you think it's fit that you place over us Umar, that you appoint Umar as the next, your next kin in power, the next in power, you place Umar as your successor? Do you think that's something fit that you should do? Do you think it's a wise decision? They said that to Umar, and they said that to Abu Bakr. Do you think it's a wise decision to place Umar over us and to make him the next leader after you go, to make him your successor? Do you think it's a wise decision? And you are heading towards Allah and he's going to count you for it. And then look what he said, Abu Bakr. He said, they said to him, when you meet Allah, what are you going to say? What's your response? You have an answer. When Allah asks you, why did you place Umar over these people? What are you going to say? He said, وَلَّيْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ خَيْرًا. I will say to Allah Azza wa Jalla that I appointed the best person I knew for them. Because Umar, the people, the reason why they were concerned is because he was strong. And they were used to Abu Bakr, who was soft. Umar was strong. As we mentioned before, the statement of the Prophet ﷺ, when he said, "Arhamu ummati," the most merciful person of my ummah is Abu Bakr. Wa ashadduha, and the one who is the strongest upon the religion, and he's like that, is Umar radiallahu anhu. ولذلك Abdullah ibn Mas'ud mentioned, إِذَا ذُكِّرَ الصَّالِحُونَ, if the righteous people are mentioned, فَحَيَّ هَلَا بِعُمَرَ. Umar is mentioned there. He's in that list. إن عمر كان أعلمنا بكتاب الله وأفقهنا في دين الله. عبد الله بن مسعود said that Umar had more knowledgeable in the book of Allah than all of us, and he had more fiqh in the deen of Allah تبارك وتعالى than us. عبد الله بن مسعود saying this, by the way, right? عبد الله بن مسعود was a عالم of the Quran. Also عبد الله بن مسعود, he said, لو أن علم عمر وضع في كفة ميزان. If the knowledge of Umar was placed on one side of the scale, وَوُضِعَ عِلْمُ أَحْيَاءِ الْأَرْضِ, and if all the other remaining people on this earth, their knowledge was being placed on the other side, فِي كِفَةٍ لَرَجَحَ عِلْمُ عُمَرَ بِعِلْمِهِمْ. علم of, يعني, لَرَجَحَ عِلْمُ عُمَرَ بِعِلْمِهِمْ. Umar's knowledge will be greater and higher than their knowledge. That's the type of knowledge he had. Abdullah ibn Umar also said, ما رأيت أحدا قط. Abdullah ibn Umar, he said, I haven't seen anyone بعد رسول الله, after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, من حين قبض أجد ولا أجود من عمر. More serious, يعني more authentic, more serious, more staunch than Umar رضي الله عنه. That's the type of person he was. One day his two children came to him one day, Umar radiallahu anhu, عكرمة ابن خالد and other than him mentioned that Hafsa and Abdullah ibn Umar, both of them, Hafsa is the daughter of Umar and Abdullah is also the son of Umar. So they both came to their father, and other than them two, they came to their father and they spoke to him. فقالوا, they said to him, لو أكلت طعاما طيبا, Umar, why don't you eat good food? كان أقوى لك على الحق, it will help you in the truth and in the hard work that you're doing. It will help you if you eat good food. And then he said to them, قال أكلكم على هذا الرأي, all of you are all of that opinion. يعني Hafsa, do you believe that as well? She said yes. Abdullah, do you believe that as well? He said yes, dad. He asked the other people there, do you all believe that? They said yes. قالوا نعم. Then he said to them, قد علمت نصحكم, I've come to know your sincere advice for me. I know you're all concerned for me. I know you all mean good for me. ولكني تركت صاحبي, but I have left my two friends. And who is he referring to here? النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the prophet. And also أبا بكر, and أبو بكر رضي الله تعالى, على جادة. I've known them to be upon a path. يعني this path I'm on is the path they were upon. فإن تركت جادتهما, and if I leave their path, لم أدركهما في المنزل, I won't reach the house, the goal that they reached. I won't be able to. So I can't get off that path. But I can see that you guys are trying to be sincere in your advice to me. ولذلك, a year from within the time of Umar's Khilafah, a sana happened, يعني القحط, it happened. And it was mentioned that he never ate yogurt and anything like that. He was eating very basic, to the extent that his stomach bloated, Umar radiallahu anhu, because of يعني what type of food that he was eating. قتادة بن دعامة السدوسي, he said, كان عمر يلبس وهو خليفة, عمر used to wear whilst he was a خليفة, جبة من صوف, he used to wear a big jubba made of صوف, okay, مرقوعة بعضها بأدم, and by it was stitched, by the way, ويطوف, and he used to, يعني it was all stitched and together, إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون, ويطوف في الأسواق, and he will parade the market, وعلى عاتقه الدرة يؤدب الناس بها, he had a stick where he would discipline the people, he would hit the people, you don't do this, don't do this, ويمر بالنكث والنوى فيلقطه ويلقيه في منازل الناس لينتفعوا به, and whenever he would find يعني people dropping dates, he would pick them up, عمر رضي الله عنه, and he would throw at people's houses so they could benefit and eat it. And if he saw that dates were يعني dropped from people's belongings and things like that, he would collect all of that and he would throw it at people's houses so they can benefit from it and eat it and utilize it. Abdullah ibn Amir ibn Rabi'ah, he said, حججتُ مع عمر, I did Hajj with Umar. فما ضرب فسطاطا ولا خباء, he never made any tent for himself. كان يلقي الكساء والنطع على الشجرة ويستظل تحته, he just took a cloth and he placed it on top of a tree and he stayed under that. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. Abdullah ibn Amir ibn Rabi'ah says that I did Hajj with Umar and he did not place for himself a tent. He didn't do any of that. All he did was he took a cloth, he placed it on top of a tree and he went under that. Brothers and sisters, if you've done Hajj, you would know the importance of tents. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, you would know the importance of tents. Nowadays, the tents have air conditioner. Yani, so much things. Water supply, this and that. This is Amirul Mu'mineen. Umar ibn al-Khattab, no tent. Al-Mutallib ibn Ziyad, he's mentioned from Abdullah ibn Isa, كان في وجه عمر بن الخطاب خطان أسودان من البكاء. Umar's face, there was a black line that ran on his cheek. And they said that this was because of his excessive crying. The crying, that he used to cry a lot. حذيفة بن اليمان, he said, والله ما أعرف رجلا. He said, I don't know any man. يعني والله ما أعرف رجلا. I don't know any man. لا تأخذه في الله لومة لائم إلا عمر. I don't know any individual that the blame of the blamer does not worry him or concern him, except Umar. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the blame of the blamer cannot influence him. He was a person qawwalan bil haqqi, the truth will be uttered, the haqq will be done. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he didn't fear what someone might say. If it's the truth, if it's the haqq, Umar radiallahu anhu wasn't scared. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Ibrahim ibn Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf, the son of Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf, he said, "Utiya Umar bi kunuzin, ama utiya Umar bi kunuzi Kisra." The leader, Kisra, his kunuz, his treasures were brought to Umar after the Muslims conquered it. And Abdullah ibn al-Arqam, he said to Umar, yani was placed in front of Umar. And Abdullah ibn al-Arqam came to Umar and he said to him, "Atajualuha fi bayti, fi bayti al-mali? Are you going to place this wealth and all of this in the bayti al-mal? Hatta taqsimha, so you can then divide it and give it to the rightful people?" فقال عمر, عمر said, "لا والله, by Allah I swear, لا أويها إلى سقف حتى أمضيها." I'm not going to place this in the same roof as my house. Get it outside and place it somewhere else. فوضع في وسط المسجد. They took it to the masjid and they placed it in the middle of the masjid. وباتوا يحرسونها, and there were security guards that were protecting it. فلما أصبح كشف عنها فرأى من الحمراء والبيضاء ما يكاد يتلألأ. Umar stood over it, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he looked at it and he saw the gold, pearls, diamonds, the things that were there, millions that were there. فَبَكَى عُمَرْ cried. فَقِيلَ لَهُ, they said to him, مَا يُبْكِيكَ يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, why are you crying, the leader of the believers? And then he said, فَوَاللَّهِ إِنَّ هَذَا لَيَوْمُ شُكْرٍ وَسُرُورٍ. Sorry, they said to him, why are you crying? Today is not a day to cry. It's a day of gratitude. It's a day of happiness. You shouldn't be crying. You should be happy that we've conquered that land and its gold and its wealth. And then he said, وَيْحَكْ, destruction. إِنَّ هَذَا لَمْ يُعْطَهَا فَإِنَّ هَذَا لَمْ يُعْطَهَ قَوْمٌ إِلَّا أُلْقِيَتْ بَيْنَهُمُ الْعَدَاوَةُ وَالْبَغْضَاءُ. That this is never ever placed amongst a people except that it brings amongst them hate and animosity. When this comes, people start to have hate and animosity. Allahu Akbar. Sufyan al-Thawri, he mentioned, من زعم أن عليا كان أحق بالولاية من أبي بكر وعمر فقد أخطأ أبا بكر فقد خط أبا بكر وعمر والمهاجرين والأنصار. Anybody who claims that Ali was more fitter for leadership than Abi Bakr and Umar, فقد خط أبا بكر, that person has said Abu Bakr is wrong. وعمر, and he's also saying Umar is wrong. والمهاجرين والأنصار, and he's also saying the مهاجرين and the أنصار were all wrong when they appointed Abi Bakr and Umar. All of them are wrong. Shariqin, he mentions, لَيْسَ يُقَدَّمُ عَلِيًّا عَلَى أَبِي بَكْرٍ وَعُمَرَ أَحَدٌ فِيهِ خَيْرٌ. There's no one who has any good in himself that would put Ali before Abi Bakr and Umar. رضي الله تعالى عنه. الحسن بن صالح بن حي, he said, سمعت جعفر بن محمد الصادق يقول, أنا بريء ممن ذكر أبا بكر وعمر إلا بخير. The Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq said, I am free. أنا بريء, I am free. From who? ممن ذكر, anyone who mentions Abu Bakr and Umar in that which is bad. I'm free from them. If he mentions them in good, alhamdulillah. But if he mentions those two, I'm free from them. I have nothing to do with them. How did Umar radiallahu anhu pass away and die? Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the city of Medina, when he did his Hajj, first of all, he left Mina. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Sa'id ibn Musayyab mentions, he said, when Umar radiallahu anhu did his sermon, his reminder in Mina, and he gave the people the reminder, Umar radiallahu anhu raised his hands to the sky. And he begged Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and he said, Allahumma kabbarat sinni, my age has now become, I'm old now. Wa da'ufat quwwati, and my strength has now become low. I'm not as strong as I used to be. And I'm not as young and as enthusiastic as I used to be. I'm old now, I've aged. وانتشرت رعيتي. And my, يعني the Islamic empire has grown and spread and it's more people now that I have to govern over. فاقبضني إليك غير مضيع ولا مفرط. Oh Allah, take my life without forsaking me. Oh Allah, and allow me not to go extreme. Sa'id Musayyib mentions, فَمَنْ سَلَخَ ذُو الْحِجَّةِ حَتَّى طُعِنَ فَمَاتْ. ذُو الْحِجَّةِ did not finish except that Umar رضي الله عنه was killed. Also, Aslam mentioned that Umar رضي الله عنه did the dua he specifically made. Also, Bukhari narrated it was, اللهم ارزقني شهادة في سبيلك. This was another dua he made. He said, oh Allah, give me martyrdom, shahada in your path. وَجْعَلْ مَوْتِي فِي بَلَدِ رَسُولِكِ. And make my death in the land of your messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم. The way he died, Umar رضي الله عنه, and he was taken, was الزهري محمد بن شهاب الزهري mentions. He said that كان Umar had a way that he would not let any of the يعني non-Muslim slaves who've reached age of puberty to enter Medina. He will never let them. Until one day Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah, he came to Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه and he said, يعني مغيرة was in Kufa. مغيرة wrote a letter to Umar رضي الله عنه, okay, mentioning to him that there was a young boy who wants to enter Medina and he has something to offer. He'll be beneficial for the people. He's a haddad, he's a carpenter, he's a blacksmith as well. You know, he's got a lot of things under his belt, okay? He's a najjar, haddad, naqqash, you know, he's got a lot of things he can do. So he said, please let him into Medina. Don't stop him from entering Medina. فأذن له أن يرسل به. عمر رضي الله عنه allowed him to be entered. He said, only come in. Mughira, the money that he wrote for this young boy, because he was his slave, was 100 dirham في الشهر. He used to give him 100 dirhams the whole month. Okay? So this young boy came to عمر رضي الله عنه complaining. And he said that the money that Mughira has given me is so little, and the work is too much. Okay? So Umar رضي الله عنه assessed the situation and looked into it and he said to him, what Mughir is doing to you is not wrong. It's fair. It's fine. It's fair. No problem. Carry on working. So this young boy, he left. ساخطاً يتدمر. He was upset and angry and frustrated. But what he did was, he made a plan to take the life of Umar. He took a sharp blade. He hid it inside the masjid that he was working on for an entire month. This blade, he was placing in the fire. He was putting poison on it. He kept putting it in the fire, poisoning it. And then finally, he put it inside the masjid, the corner of the masjid. And he entered the masjid. When he entered the masjid, Umar رضي الله عنه looked behind at the people and he said to them, straighten the lines. Straighten the lines, everyone. He said, so صفوفكم. Straighten your lines. And Umar رضي الله عنه, he started the prayer. Salah started, Umar رضي الله عنه started to lead the prayer. And what he did was, he placed the dagger that he made and he put it in the shoulder of Umar رضي الله عنه. Umar fell on the ground and when he tried to come out after he dug Umar, he wanted to go through the lines. What happened was, because the Sahabas were very close to each other in the Salah, which is the way it should be, they were so close. كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْشُوسٌ. It was like cemented bricks onto one another. The Sahabas were very tight. In order to get out, he couldn't get out. There was no place for him to come out. So what he did was he pierced 13 men there, 6 of which died. And Umar was taken to his family. The sun was about to set. The sun was about to come out because it was Fajr that he was leading. Okay? The sun was about to come out. So Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, as soon as Umar dropped, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf came forward. He led the people with two short swords. Then the people started to enter onto Umar radiallahu anhu. As soon as the salah finished, everyone went to Umar's house, wanting to know what it was, and they kept praising Umar radiallahu anhu. You were, you are, this and that. Umar radiallahu anhu, he requested for his son to make him a small little pillow from the earth. So Abdullah ibn Umar brought the sand together, and Umar put his head there. People were praising him, speaking highly of him, and he kept saying to them, Wallahi, well, he said, Wallahi ma waditu anni kharajtu minha kifafan la alayya wala li. I wish I could leave this world, nothing for me, nothing against me. Wa anna suhbata rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wasallam salimat li. And the only thing I can have with me is the companionship of Nabi Muhammad, the only thing. Abdullah ibn Abbas entered onto him and he praised him. فقال, he said to him as well, لو أن لي طلاع الأرض ذهبا. If I had this earth full of gold, left a day to be من هول المطلع. I would pay all of that just to not go through the distress of the day of judgment. Then he said, I have made a shura, a committee of people. These people are Uthman and Ali and Talha and Zubair ibn Awam and Abdul Rahman ibn Auf and Sa'ad. Okay? And he said to the Salah should be led by Suhaib. Let Suhaib lead the people of the Salah. And he said, my son, Abdullah, he's with you guys, but you can't choose him. Don't point my son. Let my son be with you, stay with you guys, but you can't choose him. Then he said, who is the man who did this to me, who pierced a blade in me? Was he a Muslim? And they said, no, he's not. He wasn't a Muslim. He was that young boy of Mughira sent to you. His name is Abu Lu'la al-Majusiya. He was a Majusi, a fire worshipper, a Zoroastrian. His name was called Abu Lu'lu. He was the one who did this to you. And then Umar radiallahu anhu said, Alhamdulillah, الذي لم يجعل منيتي بيدي رجل يدعي الإسلام. Alhamdulillah. Praises to Allah that my death is not on the hands of a believer. Look how he was worried that he might be a believer. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Then he said to his son, Abdullah, come here. He said, go to Aisha. Ask her, say to her, يستأذن عمر أن يدفن مع صاحبي. Umar is requesting that he get buried next to his two friends, Ya Rasulullah and Abu Bakr. He went to her, Abdullah ibn Umar. He said to her, that my father is requesting if he can be buried next to his two friends. Aisha, she said, كنت أريده. I wanted it for myself. That place, I wanted it for what? كنت أريده لنفسي. I wanted it for myself. But she said, ولا أؤثرنه اليوم على نفسي. I will choose Umar over myself. I'll give it to him, she said. I'll let him take it. So Abdullah ibn Umar came back to his father and he said to his father, he said, قد أذنت لك فحمد الله. She has given you permission. She said, no problem. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Alhamdulillah, praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was mentioned Aisha, from the day that Umar was buried in that room, she used to wear hijab in the house. She would cover herself. Radiallahu ta'ala anha. May Allah be pleased with our mother Aisha. Umar is dead. He's not alive. Ma'adhalika shyness. What about my beloved brothers and sisters? What about my sisters, who are out there, who are taking off their hijab, who are not covering themselves, and there are men looking at them, placing it on social media? Then our mother, Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Umm al-Mu'minina Hafsa, she entered to her father. She spoke to her father and she talked to him about everything that she wanted to talk to him about. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he spoke to his daughter and he spoke to the people around him, and after that he passed away. Jarir ibn Abdullah, he said, سُمِعَ مُعَاوِيَةُ يَخْطُبُ. It was heard that Muawiyah was doing a khutbah in Sham, and he was saying, مَاتَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ وَهُوَ ابْنُ 63 سَنَةً وَأَبُو بَكَرُ وَعُمَرُ وَهُمَّ ابْنَا 63 سَنَةً. يعني أبو, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he died when he was 63. And Abu Bakr and Umar also died when they were 63. I'm going to conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.